It's always a good idea to practice as many problems as possible before walking into an interview. As you know, it's not always guaranteed that whatever you have practiced, the interviewer is going to ask you questions from that. But whatever you have practiced gives you the idea to tackle a new problem. Well, in this video, I'm going to show you another problem which was asked to me in my AppDynamics interview. And I'm going to show you the ideas which helped me to tackle that problem and give me an optimal solution. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. All right. So the problem is, I'm given a positive integer n. Let me just change the color to. All right. So I'm given a positive integer n, right, which can be 1, 2, 3, or n, any value. And for any given value, like for suppose n equal to 1, I print 1. For n equal to 2, I have to print 1 in the center and it's surrounded by 2 all the way. For n equal to 3, I print 1 in the center, then the same pattern for 2, and then I print for the same, the outer boundary is now considered with 3s. So similarly, if it were 4, then it will be 1, 2, 2, 2, and then 1, 2, 3, 5. And then 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So something like this. I hope the problem statement is clear to you guys. Well, before jumping into the algorithm section, a quick reminder for you guys. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, then please click on that red subscribe button and also turn on all the notifications by tapping on the bell icon. And whenever you like some video, please give that video a thumbs up so that it can reach a lot more people. And now let's continue with discussing the algorithm. So the algorithm for this problem is kind of similar to the problem of spirally printing a matrix. Kind of similar, exactly similar. So what I'm gonna do is like let's consider the case for 3, right? So I'm gonna say 1 in 1, 3, 2, 2, 2, 2, and then 3s. Right? So this is the case when the, we have for n equal to 3, right? So first of all, we need to see what's the dimension of the things that we're going to print. So for any given number, we have to see what's the dimension of this. So for n equal to 1, the dimension was 1. For n equal to 2, the dimension was 3, 3 cross 3, right? So 3. For n equal to 3, the dimension is 5 cross 5, right? So we can write 5. So if you see this pattern, what is it? For given n, this number is equal to 2 times n minus 1. So size of the matrix is 2n minus 1, 2n minus 1. It's a square matrix, right? Always. Now, what we have is, let's say consider the case for 2. We can again do this in the analogy of the same spirally printing matrix, right? We can have a top row, a right column, a bottom row, and a left column, right? And we can initialize the values. So we can say something like for bottom will be 2n minus 1, then right will be 2n minus 1, and then left will be 0, right? And then what we do is every time we move from left to right in the top row, then we go from top to bottom in the right column. So I'm going to draw an arrow like this, then you go from right to left at the bottom row, then from bottom to top in the leftmost column. And after we have completed one full circle, we come here. So basically, we increment top, decrement right, decrement bottom, and increment left. So we come into the inner column, or basically the inner matrix, inner box of the pattern, right? And that's how we continue. Let's move on to implementation, and then I think it will be even more clear to you guys. So now let's talk about implementation. I'll go slow, step by step, so that we can understand each and everything happening, right? So first of all, some basic template code, including the standard library is required for input IO. Return 0, and then let's see. So we have n given to us, right? So we'll take the input n. Right now, we need to figure out the size of the matrix. What was the size of the matrix? It was 2 into n minus 1, right? So I'll say int size is 2 into n minus 1, right? So we define a matrix of size, right? And then we initialize the pointers as discussed in the algorithm section, top, right, bottom, left. So top will be at 0 initially, right will be at 2 into n minus 1 minus 1, which is 2 into n minus 2. Why do I keep saying 2 power n? Bottom will also be at 2 into n minus 2, and left will be at 0, right? Just decrease the size. Yeah, this is fine. And now I have to fill in this order. So let's do this. We are in the topmost row going from left to right. For int I equal to left, I less than right, less than equal to right, because 2n minus 2 is including the last index, right? If I were to write I less than right, then it would have been 2n minus 1 only, right? I'm including it. So I plus plus. Then we are going from left to right in the topmost row. So row is constant. So mat of top comma I equals Rn. Right? And then again, we go from in the rightmost column, we go from top to bottom. So for I equal to top, I less than equal to bottom, I plus plus, right? And then row is changing and column is right. Right? And then one half cycle complete. Now we go from right to left in the bottommost row. So for I equal to right, I greater than equal to left, I minus minus, we did not assign n over here, right? So we just quickly do that. So mat of here the row is bottom and column is changing, should be equal to the number, right? Now the last step, to go from bottom to top in the leftmost column. So for I equal to bottom, I greater than equal to top, I minus minus, mat of here the rows are changing and the column is constant. So row is changing and the column is left, equal to n, right? So you've completed one circle. So we have to move to the inner matrix now. How we do that? Incrementing top, coming one step behind the right, coming one step up from bottom, and coming one step ahead from left. So we'll do top plus plus, right? Coming one step behind from right, right minus minus, coming one step up from bottom, so bottom minus minus, and one step ahead from left, so left plus plus, right? And then we have to fill the row. So for example, for n equal to 3, we'd have done this 3, 3, 3, 3. Now we move to the inner matrix and we have to fill 2. So we have to decrease this n somehow, right? So I'll run this loop while n greater than 0. While n is greater than 0, do all these operations, right? After these also will go inside the loop only, because after we've completed one full circle, one full rotation, you basically do these things to reach the inner matrix. Okay? This is done, and then only thing we need to do is do n minus minus to decrease the number, so that we print 2. Okay, so far so good. Now let's just print the matrix. For int I equal to 0, I less than size, plus plus. For int j equal to 0, j less than size, j plus plus. Yow mat ij space. And well, let's just quickly take a look again. So we have an input n, we take it as the input, we determine the size of the matrix 2n minus 1. Then we declare a matrix of the given size. We have our top initialized to 0, right to 2n minus 2, bottom to 2n minus 2, and left is 0. Why 2n minus 2? Because the boundary for the size is 2n minus 1. And if you have to include it, like because the indexing starts from 0, we do 2n minus 1 minus 1, which is 2n minus 2. And while we have number to put, like suppose we start with 3, we'll put 3, then 2, then 1. So while we have our number is greater than 0, complete this circle process. So go from left to right in the top row, then from top to bottom in the right column, then from right to left in the bottom row, and from bottom to top in the leftmost column. And then top, move one step below from the top, one step towards left from the right, one step towards top from the bottom, and one step towards right from the left to reach the inner matrix. And decrease the value of n. Right, so let's try this out. So we have hyphen 10 code.cpp. Okay, I've made a mistake somewhere for it. Okay, I did not even. Okay, right. Now let's compile. All right, let's give 3. Wow, we get the pattern for it. Let me just make this little bigger. 3. So let's give 1. Let's give 2. Let's give 5. Let's give 6. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Cool. Nice. So that's how we implement this problem. Implemented this problem basically without any troubles. So well, another day, another matrix problem taken down. If you guys enjoyed watching this video, give this video a thumbs up and please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.